Kung Fu Panda 2, it is a great film in its own right. From the characters, to the story, to even the voice cast, this is a film that I had highly enjoyed just as much as the first movie. DreamWorks always knows how to make great animation films, huh? So the story of this sequel is that Paul and his friends, Tigress, Monkey, Crane, Viper, and Mantis, they got to travel to Gourmet City to stop the evil pin cop, Shen, from conquering China with a new weapon. Meanwhile, Paul wants to know where he comes from and what happened to his parents because he is remembering memories from his childhood. And from there, it's one of the best sequels when it comes to animation that I have seen over the years. This movie does what a sequel is supposed to do. It expands the story, it makes the friendships between the characters stronger, and overall, it's very entertaining as well. One thing I will say is that the voice cast once again delivers. Jack Black, his voice as Paul is so great that you don't even realize it's him because he sounds so different than what he normally sounds like in his other movies. At the end of the day though, this is a movie I would say is just as good as the first film. And quite frankly, even more than a decade later, it is still a joy to watch. What I really like about this film though is how consistent it is. Like for example, learning more about Paul's backstory, learning where his parents, you know, where he came from. And matter of fact, this film does explore that. I also have to say the Furious 5, they get more time to shine in this one. Not that they didn't shine in the first film, but because this being the sequel, the friendship between Paul and them are much stronger, you know, they're there for each other. And there's a nice tender moment between Tigress and Paul later on in this movie. Now, one thing I will say that I really had issue with was the villain. Like, Shen, he wasn't a great antagonist, to be honest. You know, he's that simple villain who wants power, who wants to destroy, you know, everything. And I really didn't get his motivations. I understood where it was coming from, but it was kind of shallow. And it made me wish they didn't get rid of Tai Lung from the first movie. Say what you will about that character, at least he had an interesting backstory, but a mere fact that they just got rid of him, I was like, this movie really could use a strong antagonist. Overall, also another character that took a back seat, speaking of which, it is Master Shifu. Now I get it, this film is supposed to focus more on the Furious 5 and Paul, but it would have been cool if he showed up a little bit more. He does show up like near the end, but for the most part, he's not the main focus of this film. It makes sense considering, you know, he has such a large part to play in the first movie. But overall, I think there are some new characters that could have been explored a little bit more within this film. But nonetheless, this is a movie I had enjoyed. I was entertained. I was not bored. But I just wanted this film to offer a little bit more. Not a bad film by any stretch of the imagination. I like this movie. And it's quite hard to say if this film is better, in my opinion, to the first film. But overall, I think this film is quite a thrilling ride, to say the least. I'm giving this film an 8 out of 10. I like how this one sets up events for the third film. This is a great sequel to the first movie, which I had loved so much. So to see Paul become even a better character by end this movie, it makes this one all the more better in my opinion. This film is also very funny and also teaches the message about learning to let the past go and learn to live in the moment as well. But overall, I had a very fun time with this movie. I would highly recommend it, and especially a film that everyone must check out. And that is my review of Kung Fu Panda 2. Alright, leave your comments down below in the section and let me know what you think about this movie. My review of Kung Fu Panda 3 is coming up next. Okay, this is Slim Guy 172 saying peace out. We'll be right back.